गुड इवनिंग, आ वेरी वेलकम टू न्यूज़ टीवी 99। हमारी पिछली वीडियो में हम आपको बताए थे कि HEH निज़ाम म्यूज़ियम से कुछ चीज़ें चोरी हो गई थी, लेकिन आज टास्क फोर्स साउथ जोन टीम ने इन क्रिमिनल्स को अरेस्ट कर लिया है। टुडे 11 सितंबर 2018 को हैदराबाद कमिश्नर ऑफ पुलिस श्री अंजनी कुमार IPS सर ने एक प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस की, जिसमें इन्होंने कहा कि HEH निज़ाम म्यूज़ियम से जो चीज़ें चोरी हो गई थी उसके बारे में इन्होंने पूरी डिटेल दी और ऑफन का भी पूरी डिटेल देते हुए इन लोगों के बारे में कहा। हैदराबाद कमिश्नर ऑफ पुलिस श्री अंजनी कुमार IPS सर ने कहा कि HEH निज़ाम म्यूज़ियम में CCTV कैमरे जो कि म्यूज़ियम में थे वो बहुत पुराने हैं, और एक कैमरा जो कि अच्छे से काम कर रहा था और चोरों ने बड़ी ही चालाकी के साथ इस CCTV कैमरे के डायरेक्शन को चेंज कर दिया था, जिसकी वजह से कोई भी रिकॉर्डिंग नहीं हुई। जब हमारी क्लूज टीम ने अपनी छानबीन शुरू की तो वहां पर कोई भी फिंगरप्रिंट्स नहीं मिला, क्योंकि चोर बड़ी ही चालाकी के साथ ग्लव्स का इस्तेमाल कर रहे थे। इतना ही नहीं, जाली और अलमारी पर भी कोई भी सुराख नहीं मिल पाया। जब टास्क फोर्स साउथ जोन की टीम ने अपनी छानबीन शुरू की तब ये लोग टेरिस पर जाकर छानबीन करने लगे। तब वहाँ पर वॉल पर एरो मार्क के निशान से पता चला कि इन चोरों में से एक लेबर का काम करता है। इतना ही नहीं, ये लोग चोरी करने में मोबाइल फ़ोन का भी यूज़ नहीं करे। ये लोग बड़ी ही चालाकी के साथ अपना काम अंजाम दे रहे थे। इतना ही नहीं, CCTV कैमरे के फुटेज से पता चला कि ये लोग मोबाइल का यूज़ तो नहीं करे, बल्कि मोबाइल से टॉर्च का यूज़ ज़रूर करे। हैदराबाद कमिश्नर ऑफ पुलिस श्री अंजनी कुमार IPS सर ने मीडिया से बात करते हुए इन चोरों की पूरी डिटेल दी। इन्होंने कहा कि एक का नाम मोहम्मद गौस पाशा है, सन्ना महमूद पाशा, एज 23 ईयर, सेंटरिंग का वर्क करता है, चिंतल में राजेंद्र नगर आरा डिस्ट्रिक्ट का रहने वाला है, और दूसरे का नाम मोहम्मद मुबीन, सन्ना मोहम्मद अजीज़, एज 24 ईयर, वेल्डिंग वर्कर है और वादी महमूद राजेंद्र नगर आरा डिस्ट्रिक्ट का रहने वाला है। और ये दोनों बड़ी ही चालाकी के साथ HEH निज़ाम म्यूज़ियम से ये चीज़ें चुराए, और ये लोग चुराने के बाद ज़हीराबाद को चले गए, बाइक्स को वहाँ पर रख कर मुंबई के लिए रवाना हो गए। इन दोनों चोरों में से एक चोर गल्फ कंट्री से ताल्लुक़ रखता था और ये एक बार जेल भी जा चुका था, और इसका लोकल क्रिमिनल्स में भी रिकॉर्ड है। और इन दोनों चोरों का इरादा था कि ये सब चोरी के चीज़ों को इंटरनेशनल मार्केटिंग में बेचे और अच्छी से अच्छी रकम हासिल कर सके, या फिर नीलामी में इन चीज़ों को डाले जिससे अच्छी से अच्छी रकम आ सके और ये लोग ऐश व आराम की ज़िंदगी गुजार सके। हैदराबाद कमिश्नर ऑफ पुलिस श्री अंजनी कुमार IPS सर ने ये सब चोरी हुई से चीज़ों की वेट और इसके प्राइस का भी कीमत बताई। टिफ़िन बॉक्स जो कि 1950 ग्राम्स का है, गोल्ड कप 172 ग्राम्स का है, गोल्ड टी स्पून 14 ग्राम का है, इन सब चीज़ों की जुमला रकम 2.5 करोड़ रुपए बताई जाती है। आखिरकार ये शातिर मुजरिम अब पुलिस की हिरासत में है, और ये दोनों शातिर मुजरिम को राजेंद्र नगर और हिमा सागर के बीच से अरेस्ट किया गया और आज ये पुलिस की हिरासत में है। टास्क फोर्स साउथ जोन टीम ने बहुत ही अच्छी तरीके से इस केस को हैंडल किया और CC टीम ने भी बहुत ही अच्छा काम अंजाम दिया। और ऐसी ही खास खबरों के लिए बने रहिए, कोई और चैनल नहीं है, आपका अपना चैनल न्यूज़ टीवी 99 से।
In the museum which is named after His Exalted Highness the Nizam of Hyderabad, which is custodian of one of the most precious items of Nizam family and Nizam government, when Nizam was celebrating the golden jubilee of his accession to the throne, all the royalties of the world, all the royal families, the kings and the queens, they had donated lots of precious item to the Nizam of Hyderabad. This particular golden box, golden tiffin box, which is studded with diamond, and golden cup, saucer and spoon, also studded with emeralds and ruby, these items were committed theft. It was a very sensational case. It was more than a property offense, because the city of Hyderabad and all of us, we see these things as symbol of our history, symbol of our heritage, symbol of our culture. So it was a very emotional issue. It was a very emotional thing for the entire society. and the Hyderabad city police took it as a challenge. Immediately, all of us visited the scene of crime. The CCS team, South Zone team, and South Zone Task Force team, they all swung into action. Analysis was made of all the crime scene, and to our initial information, we could get only two information. One was the rope mark on the wall, which was done because the criminals, the offenders, had used rope to slither down into the hall from the rooftop. They had removed the grill from one of the ventilator and come down into the hall and taken away these things. The CCTV camera which was there in the museum was very old, and one particular camera, the offenders, they had changed the direction by putting their foot on it, so there was no recording inside the museum. When our clues team entered the hall and we tried to pick up the fingerprint, to our surprise, we were not able to get any fingerprint because the criminals were using hand gloves. As a result, there was no fingerprint either at the grill or at the Almira or at any other point. When we went on the rooftop, then we saw, to our surprise, that there is an arrow mark. There was an arrow mark, freshly made arrow mark, a typical way of doing something which a mason worker, a tapi worker does it. That gave us a big clue that whoever has done this offense, he has some idea of masonry work. The offenders were so smart, so cunning, they were foxing the police at every stage. In one of the video camera, because we were analyzing all the cameras, so in one of the thing, their picture was there, but they were seen using cell phone. But actually, in the tower analysis, nothing was coming because they were not using SIM card. It was only to show the police to mislead them. In fact, during the commission of the offense, they were using the cell phone only as a torch because it was dark inside. So our initial effort went into the wrong direction, and we had to depend on human intelligence regarding collection of evidence. As you know, the Hyderabad City Police Task Force, particularly Task Force of South Zone and East Zone, they have lot of contacts, lot of information. So they were working on this tapi worker clue that somebody is there who has this experience of tapi worker. Meanwhile, the offenders, they went to Zahirabad, parked their motorcycle there, and took a bus to go to Bombay. The purpose of going to Mumbai was two. First, they wanted to have some good time to enjoy life. They took services of some call girls there. And secondly, one of the offender who has link with Gulf countries, because when he was living in Gulf countries, he was convicted in a small case, and in that he was also imprisoned. During the prison time, he made contact with lot of local criminals and international criminal. And perhaps one of the objective of these two people going to Bombay was to contact the internal criminals or gangs, international criminals or gangs, so that they can get a very good price. As you know, these antique items, their value is more than the weight of the gold and the diamond and the rubies which they have. As far as weight is concerned, it is 1900 plus gram, which will come to about 1.5 crores or 2 crores maximum. But in international market, some of those people who deal with art and art product and antique product, they say that the price is, nobody can estimate it because it all depends on auction. Sometimes the auction can be of 80 crores, 100 crores, 120 crores. So this was the challenge before us. And lot of diversionary tactics. They were diverting the attention of the police. As I told you, they use gloves so that there is no fingerprint. First time when they did the recce of the museum, it was done more than 30 days back. As you know, whenever there is a recording done by CCTV, the storage is only up to 30 days. So if they have done recce 30 days prior to that, their picture will not come up in the recording. Similarly, they were also, after commission of the offence, at the spot itself, they changed their dress. From t-shirt, they changed into a shirt. And as you see in the picture also, it is there. Then similarly, they were covering their face in such a way that they should not be seen. So these were the challenges, and it was a combination of tech intelligence, human intelligence, and as I told you, the clue from Tapi mystery work, from that clue, the South Zone Task Force, they developed that story, they developed that entire thread and detected the case, and it was through their reliable source, they got that these people are hiding somewhere between Rajendra Nagar and Himayat Sagar. So our team went there and they were arrested. One of the good thing is that the entire property is recovered intact. All the items, the golden tiffin box, the cups and saucer, the golden tea, the teaspoon, and those precious items like ruby, emeralds and diamond. So on this occasion, I would like to congratulate and thank all the teams of task force who have worked in this regard with coordination from South Zone and CCS. As you know, South Zone Task Force is headed by Additional DCP Chaitanya Kumar, who led the entire operation, and under him there were series of teams who were working. One team was under Madhumohan Reddy Inspector, Sub-Inspector Verma, who was analyzing the entire entry route, Sub-Inspector Takiuddin, who was analyzing the entire exit route, SI Venkatrami Reddy, who was doing the verification of all the school colleges, collection of information about bike, e-chalan, comparison of photos, CCTV footage. Sub-Inspector Sri Sailam, he also did excellent work. And the entire effort goes to the teamwork in which DCP South, Additional CP Crime, her team, and Task Force, Additional DCP, and his team, the entire team, they detected the case and recovered the property in a record time in less than a week. Thank you so much.
This news is sponsored by
Khalam Girls Junior College, ladkiyon ki taleem ka miyari markaz, jahan bahut hi umda mahol mein taleem di jati hai. Highly trained faculty ki zair nigrani, CEC, MEC, MPC, YPC courses chalaye ja rahe hain. Mukammal angrezi mahol aur taleem ke alawa educational field trips aur awareness programs. ट्रांसपोर्ट फैसिलिटी की सहूलत के साथ मुसलसिल 4 साल से लगातार 100% कामयाब नताइज दाखिले जारी हैं. आज ही तशरीफ लाइए अपने लड़कियों के रोशन मुस्तकबिल के लिए आपका अपना इदारा खलम गर्ल्स जूनियर कॉलेज. मजीद तफसीलात के लिए DRDL रोड बाबा नगर और तारबंद रोड नज अनस मॉडल हाई स्कूल.